Also on the trip were country music artists Darryl Worley, Mark Wills, Keni Thomas, and some cheerleaders from the Dallas Cowboys. The headliner was comedian and now senator, Al Franken. Franken had written some skits for the show and brought props and costumes to go along with them. Like many USO shows before and since, the skits were full of sexual innuendo geared toward a young, male audience. As a TV host and sports broadcaster, as well as a model familiar to the audience from the covers of FHM, Maxim, and Playboy, I was only expecting to emcee and introduce the acts, but Franken said he had written a part for me that he thought would be funny, and I agreed to play along. When I saw the script, Franken had written a moment when his character comes at me for a kiss. I suspected what he was after, but I figured I could turn my head at the last minute or put my hand over his mouth to get more laughs from the crowd. On the day of the show, Franken and I were alone backstage going over our lines one last time. He said to me, "We need to rehearse the kiss." I laughed and ignored him. Then he said it again. I said something like, "Relax, Al, this isn't SNL, we don't need to rehearse the kiss." He continued to insist, and I was beginning to get uncomfortable.